In this lecture, we will talk about chromoendoscopy. Chromoendoscopy is a technique used to stain the mucosa to detect dysplastic or malignant changes, used to increase detection rate of pathologic process. Indications of chromoendoscopy are evaluation of Barrett esophagus, evaluation of esophageal adenocarcinoma, detection of gastric metaplasia and adenocarcinoma, detection and characterization of colonic polyps, surveillance of IBD. Chromoendoscopy stains should be inexpensive, readily available, applied by catheter, require pre-treatment by N-acetylcysteine to clear excess mucus, use antispasmodic to decrease motility. Chromoendoscopy stains divided into three groups. First group is vital stains, which include acetic acid, methylene blue, carisyl violet, and Logol's iodine. The second group is non-absorptive stain, which include indigo carmine. The third group is reactive stains, which include Congo red and phenol red. Vital stains include acetic acid. Acetic acid is not a coloring agent, but can enhance structural pattern. In this slide shows mucosa before staining and after staining with acetic acid. Acetic acid applied by concentration 1.5 to 3% of acetic acid sprayed in 20 mm aliquots onto esophageal mucosa. Stain the lesion more white than normal epithelium. Of acetic acid chromoendoscopy in identification of colonoscopic lesions, predict the presence of specialized columnar epithelium in the esophagus by magnification endoscopy, diagnose dysplastic squamous lesion in the cervix. The second vital stain is methylene blue. Methylene blue absorbed by intestinal and colonic epithelia because they are actively absorbing epithelia and not absorbed by squamous and gastric epithelia. Before application of methylene blue, the mucus should be removed first by spraying 10% of N-acetylcysteine to ensure homogeneous exposure of the dye. Apply 0.5% methylene blue, excess dye carefully washed by water. Methylene blue has some side effects, for example, oxidative damage of epithelial DNA with photosensitization by white endoscopy light may increase cancer risk, transient harmless blue discoloration of urine and stool. The third vital stain is carisyl violet or gentian violet, which is taken by cryptis of Leberkorn, so gives histological details, so used for cytoendoscopy as shown in this image. Carisyl violet applied by small amounts 0.05 to 0.2% dilutions to avoid excessive darkening. Uses of carisyl violet chromoendoscopy can combine with indigo carmine and methylene blue to detect small early malignant colonic changes, and can combine with confocal laser to provide accurate prediction of histology and nuclear morphology, which is called endomicroscopy, and can detect and characterize early upper gastrointestinal cancer. The fourth stain is Logol's iodine. Iodine-based solution used to demarcate dysplastic and cancerous cells in squamous epithelium. Iodine incorporated to the glycogen in the non-keratinized epithelium gives reptile skin-like endoscopic appearance. Neoblastic tissue usually has low glycogen storage, and the image beside shows the lesion by white light and the lesion after staining by local iodine. Local iodine chromoendoscopy used by application of 20 to 30 mm of 1 to 2% local iodine sprayed into suspected lesion. Local iodine chromoendoscopy has some side effects, can cause thyrotoxicosis and can cause severe allergic reaction and can cause retrosternal discomfort due to mucosal irritation. These side effects can be reduced by spraying 20 mm of 5% sodium thiosulfate solution after chromoendoscopy. The second group of chromoendoscopy stains, non-absorptive contrast stains, which include indigo carmine, which builds in the mucosal folds, allows better topographic definition. Neither reactive nor absorbed by the mucosa. Used as for dye E132. Chromoendoscopy by indigo carmine used to detect different clonic staining pattern to classify lesions according Kudu bed pattern, and used also to delineate the extent of the gastric cancer. Indigo carmine applied by concentration 0.4% and is gently applied by special dye spraying catheter to achieve entire mucosal coverage. It is safe than methylene blue as it does not affect DNA. The third group of chromoendoscopy stain is reactive stains. Reactive stains, which include Congo red, which is pH indicator that it changes color from red to dark blue or black when exposed to acid, as shown in the two images, before and after. Before application of Congo red, we should stimulate acid production by 250 microgram of pentagastrin taken orally. During endoscopy, spray 0.5% of sodium bicarb solution, then spray 0.3 to 0.5 Congo red solution. This stains delineate acid secreting areas as blue-black areas, but non-acid secreting areas appear as red. Congo red chromoendoscopy used to detect ectopic sites of acid production and used to evaluate post-vagotomy patient and used to screen early gastric cancer and used with methylene blue to detect small foci of intestinal metaplasia. The second reactive stain is phenol red, which changes the color from yellow to red in the presence of alkaline media, as shown by arrow in this image. Before application of phenol red, the patient is given acid suppressing agent, either PPI orally day before or intravenous therapy 30 to 60 minutes before the procedure. The oral anti-foaming mucolytic agent and anticholinergic drugs are given to reduce gastric motility, then the entire surface of the stomach is sprayed over with 0.1% phenol red containing 50% urea. Phenol red chromoendoscopy used to map the distribution of areas infected by Helicobacter pylori in the gastric mucosa.